Hey, what's up, guys? It's Sihk. We're straight out of Hotel BARONG right now in Bali, and we've been using these Pioneer CDJ 3000s, but powered by Pioneer DJ Indonesia. They're super kind to give us all this equipment to use while we're here. But today, since we've been using this for maybe a month plus, I'm gonna do like almost like a reaction video to it and like how I personally feel about the equipment and basically comparing it to the previous model, which would be the CDJ 2000 Nexus 2s. So come over here. Let me show you close up of the new equipment. We're just gonna be looking at one right now. The setup is four CDJ 3000s and DJM 900 Nexus. We're not gonna really focus too much on the DJM 900 Nexus 2s, but if you do get this model of CDJ 3000s, I do recommend you to get the DJM 900 Nexus 2s because they just work better together. The first thing I want to talk about basically is the jog wheel. They've updated it by a lot. There's a couple things I like, there's a couple things that I don't really like. The thing I really like is, first of all, it shows the album artwork. I don't know how useful that is, but it looks cool. You know, especially if you're doing like a live stream and maybe like an up view, you can see the album artwork. If you zoom in right here, the movement of the jog wheel, like the screen, I don't know how many hertz it's running, but it's smooth. It's smooth. It's like you can play an FPS game on here. Maybe run Doom, you know? But there is a couple things that I kind of feel is a little different to the 2000s. For example, if you go over here and you go to the jog adjust, usually I have it right in the middle, but for the 3000s, I've always had on heavy because I feel like the jog wheel itself is a lot lighter compared to the 2000 Nexuses. One thing I feel like when I have it right in the middle, it's a lot lighter compared to like the 2000s, there isn't that much weight. So let's skip towards the middle. When you spin back on middle, it's like as if you had it like maybe here on the 2000s. So when you're beat matching, when you're doing this while it's playing, and you do that, you see how fast it goes. But if you have it on heavy, it feels more natural, more closer to what I'm used to with the 2000s. Like, that's the jog wheel. That's the only changes I can really tell you. It's, there's a screen here now, and it's a lot lighter. Could be a good thing, could be a bad thing, depends on taste. Another major difference is the screen itself. If you look at the screen right here, and you compare it, I don't know, put in a picture of a CDJ 2000 somewhere on the screen right now, you can tell that this screen has basically doubled its size. I think it's a 10-inch screen, and if you look at the movement here, so you know how in the 2000s, it only showed, for example, if you have two tracks running. If you have two tracks running on the CDJ 2000 Nexuses, this is what you usually see, right? The grid line and nothing else. But now they have this option where you can actually make it into also the audio form, like audio waveform. And if you've watched some of our streams and you see us not using headphones, especially the table streams we've been doing where each one of us has one CDJ, this is how we've been mixing without headphones, because technically now it's a lot easier to beat match without headphones because you can actually see exactly how you can beat match it on the grid. And you can zoom in if it's the right tempo. Let me just make it the right tempo. But basically you can zoom in and instantly it's on the same, it's on grid. But it's really important for you to actually use Rekordbox to have all of this function. Another thing that I want to talk about the screen is when you're on the search mode, before when you want to do like, oh, I want to organize things by track, by key, you would have to press option, which that button no longer exists. You just press on the screen. This is fully touch screen, just like an iPad. You can press key, it, you know, organized by key. You press BPM, it organized by BPM. You press track, it organized by track. And another thing you can do, which I have not figured out how to do yet, but I've seen people do it, you can actually basically preview tracks without having to load it into the CDJ by just dragging your finger on here. I haven't figured out how to do it, but it's, if you see right here, it's supposed to preview the track, but I don't know. Not a, I haven't tried it out yet. Another thing that could be cool, I guess, I don't use this function too much, but I know a lot of people do, is the hot cue. You used to have four right here on the CDJ 2000 Nexus 2s. They've moved it over right here, and now you have eight, basically. You have A, B, C, A, B, C. And you can have even like D, you can have E, you can have F, you can have G, and you can have H, and can go. Interesting stuff. I rarely use that, but some people use it a lot. Another key feature, talking about keys, is that you can actually change the key of your track on the fly. And you guys remember this, the unholy sync button, right? It's like for DJs who are too lazy to beat match. Now you actually have key sync also. So right here, if you press key shift, and you, for example, you have this track going, this is a B flat track, right? So let's go back to the beginning of this track. So this is a B flat track. This is an F minor track. You can actually put this on master. You press master right here, and then you press key sync, and it'll sync to a key that harmonizes with this. Or you can even, on the fly, for example, turn off key sync, and you play this track. You can easily, let's go here. You can actually change the key on the fly. So if, for example, you're mixing something more harmonically, because most of the times when in Barong we kind of do stuff more hard, but a lot of us also make really, really melodic music. Sometimes you can't, you just can't mix like F minor to like, I don't know, a B flat or something. But now you can just find the harmony of it. Like you go to B flat right here. Next step would be a B flat. And you just keep going. You just can mix it like that, super simple. Another thing that I wanna say I wish I had on the 3000s would be this vinyl speed adjust. We used to have two, one here and one down here, which would be the start and stop. Now you have only basically one. So slow down and it starts up again. But before, you could have a slow start or maybe like a slow down when you stop, and then you can have the start to be like fast. That's a thing that I wish we still had, but I mean, I also barely use that function. People like Juyen really misses it, but that's something maybe for the next model, I don't know. But other than that, it's really dope. So another function that I really think is really, really useful is this beat jump function. So instead of pressing the search button and it goes through the track, you can actually just, while you're playing on the fly, press beat jump and it goes to the next parts of the song by 8 bars. So you're just scrolling the track like that. It's really cool. You can, I was playing around with it earlier. I was like basically making a new drop by just beat jumping. All right, so one last thing I want to talk about is the speed of the new equipment. So before, if you remember on the CDJ 2000s, I wish I had a 2000 right here to compare it, but when you load in a track, this equipment loads it in basically in an instant. So if look over here, I'm about to load in a new track right here. Boom, instant. Before CDJ 2000s, if I remember, 2000 Nexuses, when you press that load button, it'll do like this scan through thing, then it loads, which takes a couple seconds. But when you're doing stuff live and you really want to mix really quickly, having this instant load, basically a lifesaver. Also, another really useful thing, remember on the 2000s, when you, for example, accidentally unplug your USB, it loops about 4 or 8 bars. But when you're playing something here, right, and you unplug it, it has the whole track loaded up. It has the whole track loaded up, so you don't even have to worry. Like, example, you're at a festival, right? You're like, yeah, I'm playing this track right now. And then some idiot, like some DJ is like, yeah, dude, it's my turn. Unplugs your USB. On the old CDJs, you're kind of basically and it'll just loop 8 bars. And when you plug in your USB, you have to wait for it to load. Now you have the whole track loaded, and you have time to fix stuff, or you can, you know, like, oh my god, why did you pull out my USB? Start a whole mosh pit on stage. You know how it is. Also, there's another major change, which I did not notice because we never use CDs anymore. There is no more disk drive. So technically this is like an ex-DJ because there's no CD drive at all. But who uses CDs anymore, right? And yeah, that's basically all the changes that's been made between the 2000s and 3000s. All right guys, this is my honest review of the CDJ 3000s. I've been using it for a month. Shouts out Pioneer DJ Indonesia for hooking us up with the equipment for our live streams and everything. Yeah, don't forget to subscribe to Barong Family's YouTube channel. Leave a comment, leave a like, say something sick as sexy in the comments or something. And yeah. Goodbye.